Hello everyone and welcome to episode 6 of my NCT 127 series. Today is all about we are superhuman, and this was great. It was so good. I love this album, the way they sing on here, the way they rap on here. I am becoming such a huge Jungkook fan. I feel like it's going through a 2.0 era where is everywhere. Like, this makes no sense because technically ever since it's in the album he's been there, but it does make sense in my mind, in the sense that somehow now when I listen to a song I can pick him up right away. And it doesn't even have as many lines as other members. But even if it's just 2 seconds, I know that is him. And that moment will just stay in my mind. And that's why I'm saying it's going to a 2.0 era, because it's just taking over for me. And 127 is one of the NCT subunit where I have the most of my biases. But somehow Jungkook is just, yeah, it's just so amazing. I don't know how I didn't see it before, but there's something about him lately, of course, in the context of this album, because I know I'm still behind on their discography, but there's something about him in this album lately that hits really different. Same goes for Jaehyun, is also undergoing a 2.0 era, but for him it was already my bias, so it's like, oh, I'm just amazed by what he's doing once again. But with Jungkook, it's like falling in love all over again. I have this excitement, you know, when I'm about to listen to a 127 album, just to wonder what is he going to do in this one, which song is going to be the one where it just kills me. And I am loving this feeling. Of course, everybody did such a wonderful job. 127, what I love about them is they found the sweet balance between the hard eating members and the ones that are a little bit more softer, and that balance is called Jaehyun, Yuta, and Doyoung, because I feel like the three of them really bring together those two sides of 127. Jaehyun, because he can sing, he can rap, so it really is able to just be this happy medium between both side of the group. Yuta knows how to sing in harder songs, sing in softer songs. He just has this overall really nice, overwhelming and charismatic presence, and he knows how to make himself heard in the songs, even when he doesn't get enough. And then Doyoung. Doyoung is that one main vocalist that can be put in any group and it will still shine, because Doyoung understands the type of music 127 makes. I don't know how to explain this properly, but it's like he knows exactly what to give whatever the song and the vibe that they're going for. And now when I think about Power, I think about Tail, I think about Haechan, Doyoung will be that one member that is so versatile. Whatever the beat is, whatever the mood is, Doyoung will do his thing. Not that the others don't, but I feel like there's something about Doyoung that is very, very versatile, and I like it. Tail is so powerful. That is the type of per artist where when he's in the song and he's singing, he's taking over. Like, he has that overwhelming presence. It's so good, it's so powerful. And you know, the thing with Tail sometimes that I'm really shocked is he doesn't get as much as other main vocalists that I've come across ever since I've dived into group music. Because if you take away, sometimes in the song, you take away the high note and the background vocals, sometimes Dell doesn't have as much lines, as many lines as you would expect the main vocal to have. And that really puzzles me because I don't understand why. It's so amazing and his voice is so beautiful. Why? Because sometimes it felt like it's only being used for the high note or a background vocals. Why? Like, I don't understand. And that's something that really frustrates me when it comes to SM in general, because that's not the only SM group where this is happening. There's like this tendency to underutilize assets. It's like Utah is in the same situation where sometimes I feel like, why can't we hear more of Utah? Why? I don't understand. Don't get me started on Journey. I will just go on a whole rant for 2 hours. I don't understand why Journey is not used to the full office capacity. Like, he's so talented, but he just get almost nothing. He would have those 10 seconds. The thing is, because he's so charismatic, he's able to make the best of those 10 seconds, but it's still not enough. And that's something that I've expressed many times when it comes to 1 to 7, is I'm really frustrated sometimes with how just things go, because as amazing as they are now, I feel like they will be 1,000 times greater if everybody was used to their full capacity. And sometimes it's really frustrating because I know that all of them have this are just those amazing artists, but they don't get the opportunity to really showcase that. Thank God that we have the NCT albums where, because things are switched around, you get to hear a little bit more of some people. But even sometimes in the overall group albums, it will still be the same situation where some people get less than what they deserve. And an argument that has always been put forward is like, oh, maybe the song called for this particular line distribution, but why not pick songs where everybody's going to be able to shine? Because at the end of the day, they have the opportunity. I'm talking about the company here. They have the opportunity to pick songs that are going to fit everybody's vibe. So I don't understand why go again and again pick songs where some people are going to be underutilized. Like, it really frustrates me when it comes to 1 to 7, because just imagine what 1 to 7 music will be with 10% more Till, 10% more Jungwoo, 10% more Journey, 10% more Utah, like just 10%. You will see how things will just be even greater than now. And this is an issue I have with the company, not the group. I want to really emphasize it because it's not a 1 to 7 issue. It is an SM thing. It's like they do it just for the fun of it, because in every single SM group that I've checked out so far, there's always that one person that just, sometimes it's even more than one, that gets less than what they deserve. So every time I go into an album and things like this happen, even though I really enjoy the music, I can't help but feel frustrated because of that. So yeah, I just had to mention it again because now that I started thinking about the songs on the album and the members and what they did, it just reminded me of that one issue that I have, which is, why are we not utilizing everybody to their full potential? But that's just a topic for another day. I apologize. I went off course for a moment, but it's something that really just makes me a little bit sad. because I really love 1 to 7, and I just want everybody to have an opportunity to showcase what they have. But now, let's go back to the album. Like I said, it was a really great album. I love the energy. I love the singing. The rapping is amazing on here. You already know that Mark and Taeyong are going to do their thing. I love their back and forth. The way they, I feel like the two of them are the very definition of feeding on each other energy. It's like they give each other so much boost when they rap back to back. I love it. And I really, really love 1 to 7 take on the music. It's the fact that it's so unique to them. And they are not afraid to experiment. They are not afraid to go for an instrumental that will sound odd to you, but somehow they make it palatable. And I really respect them for that. Now, when it comes to favorites on this album, I have two of them, and my number two is Superhuman.
Yeah.
that was my second favorite Superhuman. This is so good. I love this song, the vocals, the rapping. I love the energy they really served with this one. I love everybody on here. They did what they were supposed to do, and this is definitely one of those that hit really, really hard. I think it's definitely one of my favorite of all time when it comes to 1 to 7. It's that good. It's definitely top 10 on my list for sure. Now, my number one in this album is Highway to Heaven.
Could you repeat? 될 때까지 부딪혀봐 like this. 한계는 없어, we limit this.
가끔씩 막막해질 땐 별일도 아니란 듯이 이 방식대로 고인지 keep on. 아침이 떠오르듯이 길을 이어져 반드시 I believe that we believe that.
Just hold my hand.
That was my favorite song in this album. So good. It's so good. Like, this album really stepped up the bar. Like, they have amazed me with their discography so far, but something is in the water lately. The albums are just becoming better and better. And I just know picking that favorite album is going to be so hard because. Whoa, I love the growth. I love how with each new albums, their sound is just becoming excellent and more excellent. And even when I think they cannot push the bar, they do it. And I am so excited because my expectations always are met and surpassed. So I really, really loved it. Let me know in the comments how you felt about this album, which song ended up being your favorite. And if you want more, check out their dedicated playlist on the channel. That's it for me today. I'll talk to you really, really soon.